It is a picture-perfect day on the campus of Florida State University. It is time to play baseball. Opening day in Tallahassee as the Seminoles welcome Oakland University from the state of Michigan to town. Tom Block and the Colonel Chip Baker with you. And Chip, there is nothing quite like opening day. There's only one of the year. Opening day is what? All across the country, a lot of college baseball. People are ready to come to the ballpark and watch baseball teams play. It is a little chilly today. I talked to Seminole star DJ Stewart a moment ago, and he said his mom sent him a text, said, you're going to be cold today. He said, Mom, you're missing the point. It's opening day, and he's ready to go. Speaking of DJ Stewart, this guy's a bona fide star, Chip. 351 a year ago, 7 homers, 50 RBI.
If you're an opposing manager, you're watching every time you know where he is in the batting order. A lot of the scouts will be at the ballpark today. He's been listed as the best hitter in the state of Florida.
Be fun to watch DJ's season start here today. Of course, Florida State, speaking of seasoning, they have a seasoned veteran on the hill in Mike Compton. Feels like pretty recently he was a freshman All-American. Now he's a grizzled veteran for FSU.
Young man came in the program 3 years ago, started a bunch of ball games as a freshman, pitched in the College World Series. He came back from Tommy John surgery. He's ready to go for Friday, opening day here at Howser.
Compton gets the ball and the call today as the Noles entertain Oakland. There is a new baseball this year, which will be significant. We'll discuss that as our broadcast gets started. But let's go ahead and take a look at the batting order for the visitors from Michigan. Little starter Mike Compton, a year ago 7-3, with an ERA just a tick under 3.25. He is a 6'2", 195-pound redshirt junior, and as you can see, he throws from the right side. And Chip, boy, he just burst on the scene a couple of years ago when he first got an opportunity to wear the garnet and gold. Has been pretty steady ever since. Several familiar faces back, most of them in the outfield, Stewart, DeLuzio, and Delph, but new infielders on the left side, Busby and Walls. John Sansone is back, Neoporti, the first baseman, and we'll tell you more about each and every one of those Seminole starters. As the game moves along, we are underway. The 2015 campaign starts with a strike from Mike Compton to Tyler Janish, the second baseman for the Oakland University Golden Grizzlies. Junior left fielder. Guy who loves coming to the ballpark, just a flat-out baseball player.
It's one of these guys, Tom, that you're sitting in the stands. Your conversation stopped when this young man stepped in the batter's box.
Feels like Florida State always has at least one of those
guys. One guy like that. See how hard he works every day he comes to the ballpark. How well he runs, you know. You see it, The big body he has, and he wears a loose uniform, but he is a very well put together hitter, baseball player, runs very well on Stewart.
2-1 now, and if you're Hager, this is the situation you'd love to see DJ Stewart, which is two outs and nobody on as he steps in. I think Oakland would take that every at bat this weekend for Stewart. DJ a year ago, that 350 average, 7 homers. 2-2.
I'll tell you what, this 6-year veteran on the mound, Hager's doing a good job of just painting the corner, breaking ball right there. Keeping it just off the outside corner right there for strike two.
Foul back, and the umpire lost some headgear.
Not afraid to go inside right there on Stewart, fouled it off. Knocks the cobwebs out of Doug Lee's mask here for the beginning of the year.
Big cut for DJ, just gets a small piece of it to stay alive. John Sansone on deck.
I think that's a big key in Florida State's lineup is who is going to hit in front of and behind Stewart, how successful they have to be, because they have to be able to protect this big guy in the lineup.
DJ Stewart, in case you're wondering, can still hit the baseball. He singles the center, first base runner of the day for the Noles. Brings up the first baseman for Florida State from Atlanta via TCC to FSU. Of Quincy Neoforti. Hits this down the left field line, and he's got a chance for extra bases. The first extra base hit of the year for the Noles will be a one-out double.
Brooke in the D1 baseball gets a pitch. Down and in right there. Just good stroke to left field. Goes all the way to the corner. Not sure what type of indoor facility Oakland University has, but working on a cutoff and relays right there, not right off the get-go. Again, it's only their second day they've been outside. It pitches. That was the ball off there.
Well, from that standpoint, something you want to see in a leadoff hitter. He's not your typical leadoff hitter for Florida State, and that he's not Tyler Holt. He's not going to go out there and steal a bunch of bases for you.
You are a batter in the order, and this guy leads the game off. You better pay attention, because you're going to see more than one or two pitches. He's going to get up here again. Six pitches already in this at-bat.
And he dribbles one between first and second for the second hit of the day for the Seminoles. First for Delph. He's been pretty consistent throughout his career, Chip, as we'll watch this again, seventh pitch of the at-bat.
I'm inside right here doing a good job of pulling those hands through and pulling that ball through the right side.
Hit 267 as a freshman, 270 as a sophomore, and 268 last year.
Tom, young players have to realize you're not happy hitting a ground ball like that, but you get down that line and beat that play out. Look who comes up the bat. You got the All-American come up the bat. Give him a chance to swing the bat with two out and runner on first. Big play on the loser just to get down to first base, give it all, and beat that play out.
50 pitches now for Hager as DJ Stewart steps in for the second time. DJ with a base hit in his first trip. And a base hit in his second trip. And now DeLuzio is going to go to third, and as I told you, he can run. He's fun to watch open up on the base paths. Runners at the corners for the Noles. Here.
Again, it wasn't really the offense that allowed the runs in the first inning. It was the three unfortunate errors by Florida State. First 3-0 count, I believe, Tom.
Has not walked anybody. Truluck was taking all the way. De La Calle on deck. Two seniors in this Florida State lineup. As Truluck gets a base hit to right.
Good job of hitting right there. Ben has been around the plate here. I guess just missed down low there with the first pitch to Delph. To DeLuzio.
This one is back up the middle, and DeLuzio has his first hit of the season. And now this is a guy that Fannin will need to pay attention to.
Fastball to State, drove it up the middle. It's always good, Tom, to get that first knock of the year. You're going to go the whole weekend, go to the last day or so, maybe into the next week, start pressing. Stewart already has two for the year, two base hits, one to left field, one he pulled his last at bat. One to center field his first at bat.
16 steals a year ago for DeLuzio, who sets his lead as Sterry will hold him on. DJ takes a call, strike one. Stewart, a pair of singles. Seminoles have at least a base hit in every inning. Had two in the third when they left the bases loaded.
Florida State coaches may be getting a time on this big right-hander on the mound. if he's slow to the plate, may start to lose you at first base. Quick throw to first. Put a stopwatch on the pitcher and see how long he takes to deliver the ball to the plate. You get an idea how long it takes your catcher to throw it, but you know how quick your runner is.
They're paying close attention to him, as they should.
Bannon on the mound does one thing base runners at first base do not like. Sits and just holds the ball. Comes to a set position with Stewart there at the plate. And he brings his hands down low, right at his waist.
Here goes DeLuzio. The pitch is low and away, ahead for a slide, and that's an easy swipe of the bag for DeLuzio. You know, we chatted with, felt they were a little top-heavy last year. When you look at the numbers for Connor Fannin, who's on the mound now, he did not have good numbers last year, so obviously they feel like he's turned a corner a little bit if he's the first ball.
The check swing, strike two. Stewart says, never see him get frustrated, seems like. You have to be a patient hitter with a guy like DeLuzio on base in front of you. He's looking for a ball he can still hit here with two strikes, but still do some damage with.
It's this one to left center field, and appropriately, D.J. Stewart will drive in the first run of the season for the Noles. Heading to second, and he'll be safe as the ball kicks away from Brasso, the shortstop. I beg your pardon, that was Yanish, the second baseman, who got knocked down by Stewart. 2-1, the Noles are on the board, and D.J. Stewart is 3-for-3. What did I say about singing O Canada, trying to start a rally in an inning where DeLuzio and Stewart are batting, Chip?
O Canada in the third time through the order. It kind of goes hand in hand there in the fifth inning. Stewart is a baseball player, Tom. His third hit of the day. Hits the ball to left center. Morton, center fielder, gets over and cuts it off. And Stewart just made that double by getting out of the box. He runs well. And a hard slide to second base.
Sansone cuts and misses.
100 hits, 100 RBIs, 100 runs, 30 home runs, 30-plus stolen bases. Pretty good baseball player.
30-plus game hit streak, too, yeah. Isn't it? DJ going for third, and he'll have that base swiped as Sansone protects him. And Yetsko didn't hold on to it cleanly.
Sansone shaking his head, but he swung the ball well off the plate.
Job. 3-1 is down the left field line, and we will be tied. Sansone delivers, and they're going to wave DJ Stewart home as well. We're not tied for long. First lead of the day for the Noles, and Sansone delivers in the four hole. A two-run double, 3-2 Noles.
Fans in the outfield are not respecting Dave West. They were juiced the opposite way. They're playing pretty shallow and left. Another throw to first.
One and oh to West. Smokes this one down the right field line. Gets past the outfielder and will be a double. How's that for Gage West? Florida State trying to break it open a little bit. Delph today is 1-for-3 with a couple of ground outs to second base. Also has walked and scored. Hits this one to right field down the line. Giving it a ride. Josh Delph has opened it up. A grand slam. And Florida State now leads 7-2.
Trying to think back, Tom. That may be his first ever career grand slam here at Florida State. Quick. Four runs on the board there with one out. Wow.